All right, so this will be Virgo Sun, Virgo Moon, and as well Virgo Rising. Weekly general tarot reading March 9th to March 15th, 2020. And in case any of you guys is interested in a personal reading with me, checking out the description down below. It's gonna give you a link to my website from which you can purchase a search. So without further ado, let's move to the reading itself. Now, the first card, which stands for the topic of your week, is going to be the Two of Wands. Moving next, we do have the energies feeding and supporting the topic here. That is to be the Eight of Pentacles. Afterwards, it is the challenges that you will have to overcome here. That is to be the Knight of Swords. The fourth card, it is the gifts and the blessings that you can enjoy throughout the week. That is to be the Queen of Wands. Furthermore, we do have the impression you leave into the people around, that is to be the Nine of Cups. And standing next and last here is will be the guidance the Tarot is offering, that will be the Ace of Swords. So those six cards here. Okay, so that week it will be rather quite busy. For what it seems, because the energies around that are feeding up the topic itself are going to increase your personal standing. I don't know how to say it, but say it that way, you will start kind of obtaining a bigger value over your efforts in general. So in other words, you will start thinking that you do deserve more, which is quite accurate looking at that reading. I mean, deserve more than what you are already having in terms of current relationship status. Again, status, not relationship, but current relationship status and a current career status as well. Here I want to make a clarification. It does not mean that the person you are with does not deserve you. It is just that the current stage, it's not enough anymore, and it's time for you to execute the next stage. That being said, it looks like that you will start having that more keen and subtle eye for the minor details around career-wise and relationship-wise as well. Everything that it is happening around that you have to tackle with, it will be addressed with appropriate conscientiousness from your behalf. And as well, your sense is going to start increasingly growing, that whatever plans you had up until now for yourself in terms of career or in terms of relationship, it's time now to start manifesting those plans, either for engagement, to get into a deeper commitment as well, to attack a position of a promotion, to jump into a lucrative project or lucrative business venture. So in addition, overall here with those energies, you are gonna feel ready to jump into a further growth or further cycle of a bigger cycle of a development. And that will provoke the situation itself, which is the Two of Wands. Now that card, when it comes to situations, it is a pretty short one. It does point that you are completely aware of your skills, capabilities, you know, knowledge, and in generally, you do have a quite accurate diagnosis over the place and the situation that you are in, and you know that you can go for more. And here it is the process of deliberation and in generally figuring out how and where. Okay, so that being said, it does depend what kind of a situation you are. We'll identify how you are to proceed forward. And I want to give you an example here. So you identify, or kind of like you understand, that you can do more in career development, but unfortunately the company you're working for, it does not offer you such a field of development. It's just a small company and there is no more room to grow there. So in that particular case, it does look like that these cards point that you will start looking for another job, okay? But if the company is big and it can offer you a bigger places for you to be at, as a bigger stages into the ladder of the hierarchy, then those cards are pointing that you will start considering how you can actually tackle an endeavor that will allow you to get promotion moving forward into the future. There are many examples that I can give you guys, but those cards here are speaking for wider vision of the future for yourself and starting to having a not exactly bigger expectations of yourself, but more like being more courageous, if you will, to approach a more difficult and bigger endeavors as well. If you will, if you have been afraid to approach a certain person you like, that fear will no longer be at place moving into this week, March 9th to March 15th, 2020. So you have to ride the tide. It is just as simple as that. I mean, whenever your senses are dragging you toward, this is what path you have to follow here. And those senses are going to be boosted or kind of like manifested through the realization of how good you can be into your career and how well you can situate yourself into your relationship. Moving next, it is the challenges that you will have to overcome. That is to be the Knight of Swords. It's a person, and these people, they constantly make excuses in that particular position not to do something. So that is just someone that you cannot really rely on for one or another reason, and they are very skilled into, like said once again, making excuses, almost to a point that they make you feel guilty of that they can't do something that they have promised that they are going to do. So these people were with quite agile intellectual properties, if you will, very smart, very cunning, and in generally very tenacious as well. But in that particular position, a challenging position, they don't do things that's out of charity, if you will. I mean, they will do things only if they like to do those things. But maybe as a friend of yours or as a suitor of yours, they could not decline what you have proposed or what you have asked, and now they're trying to find an excuse not to do it. So that will be the challenge here, not to hold them accountable, because they are not going to do it one way or another. I mean, they're going to find a way eventually to simply sever ties with their promise or with their proposition or with their incorporation in generally into the endeavor that you both are performing into. So moving next is going to be the gifts and the blessings that you can enjoy throughout the week. That is to be the Queen of Wands, and that is not the person this time around here. That represents your personality and the positive traits that you are to be gifted with. Well, not exactly. So you do have them, but the gift itself is that is going to make those traits to shine and to glimpse the rest, or to shadow the rest of the negative traits that you may have and that the people were kind of trying to criticize you about. So as a gift and blessings here, you are to show an exceptional business sense. And that will quite impress and amaze your co-workers, your supervisor, your boss as well. And in generally, is going to make you very reliable into their eyes, in a sense of that, well, let's say if they have some sort of a project that they're baffled whom to give it to, they will kind of like be impressed and say, well, maybe she or he is our person, our guy, you know, or our woman here, and we have to try it out. So let's give it to him or her and see what happens. Quite confident that they will get the hang of it and they will be able to push it through. That is because for one or another reason, you will have not just only acute business sense, but also the sense of how things works, either career-wise or either relationship-wise as well. And pretty much it will be highly unlikely that you're going to make a wrong move or a wrong step there, wrong decision taken, and etc., etc. Above everything else, it seems that also you're going to be gifted with the intuition how to press buttons into people, how to use leverages against them, your decision how you're going to use them for good or for bad. And finally, you are going to be gifted with the ability to attract. Especially when we are talking about romance and you are single, well, those cards here are only telling you guys that you have to leave the bar of expectations, meaning jump into more challenging social circles that you have been afraid to jump into because you probably thought that you are not worthy enough to be there. Well, it looks like that week is your lucky week because you are going to make an impression, and that will be a positive one. Moving next, it will be the impression that you are leaving into the people around. That is the impression of the Nine of Cups. And I don't know really how to translate this one, because people, the word is not exactly lucky, more like people will see you as a very blessed individual, as a, someone who just have their wish fulfilled, as a, someone who just have their a life filled as well with happiness, with exhilaration, with ecstasy even, with emotional satisfaction and etc. etc. So people will see you as a very happy person. That's the bottom line here. You may not be, but this is just how they are going to see you. Now you have to be careful though, because hatred is everywhere. I mean, it's just, life is all inclusive. You do have the friends and the followers. You do have the haters as well. And as haters sees you happy and successful, they may get tenacious, okay? They may get kind of like a more aggravated than before, so be careful with that. Don't allow those people to ruin your good experiences that you're gonna have throughout the week. And the last one here, it will be in term of guidance that Tarot is offering. So that touches on the very first sentences that I said about the accurate diagnosis of the situation. That is to be the Ace of Swords, and it is exactly what it says, that you are going to know how you stand, what your potentials are into the place you are in, and in generally what you have to do in order to get wherever you want to be. And if the current circumstances does not give you what you need, then there are different circumstances that are going to give you what you need in order to get wherever you want to be. And you should not hesitate to change situations, meaning changing jobs, meaning changing relationships as well, if this is what you need once again, okay? So whatever assessment you place over your job, over your relationship, over your social life throughout this week, that is going to be the accurate assessment. You will have a full vision over the truth around, so you are not to be deceived. If you are to be deceived, you are deceiving yourself with this card having it here. And yes, some of the actions you have to do, they need to be rather a bit tough, like calling tough decisions, making tough actions as well, but it is just what will be needed for you to capitalize on the potential that you just have found that you possess, but it stays here to for unexplored and uncapitalized. So that being said, Virgo, this was your weekly general tarot reading, guys. Hopefully you enjoyed it and you liked it. And once again, if you're interested in a personal reading with me, checking out the description down below is going to give you a link to my website from which you can decide what kind of a version of a reading you want. And depending of that version, I will contact you within 24 hours upon purchase to give you details how the reading is going to take place. Hopefully we're going to see each other around, and until then, bye.